Good evening. I'd like to thank all of you for coming out to the FISA System Music Fest tonight. I hope you're enjoying yourself, having a relaxing time with your friends, listening to the good music. I'd also like to take the time to thank the people who made this event happen, who work behind the scenes. Behind these wonderful performances tonight, there's an underlying message. We're striving to increase the awareness of a problem that is afflicting families across the state and even across the nation. What makes it so important is that this is happening every day to people that you know, and most people just turn their heads. The system that was originally designed to protect children is now causing untold damage to them and their families. There needs to be a stand. First, people who have not yet been affected by this need to be made aware of the issue. Then, those who have been entangled in this system need guidance to develop adequate survival skills. Children's Protective Service. Most cringe when they hear that phrase or jump automatically to defend it. I will be the first to say that CPS plays a huge role in the safety of our children. Some of the issues that children face every day would not be known if it was not for CPS. Unfortunately, the system is flawed. The whole reason that I'm here is to bring awareness to an issue that we can all work together to fix. Children are being removed from their homes and put into overcrowded foster homes, sometimes hundreds of miles away from their parents. For what? A lot of times it's minor infractions, simply bad parenting, or because the family has been set up, often by another family member or someone who is angry at them. The most common cause behind a CPS case is an anonymous angry report. So a family is ripped apart, sometimes for up to 2 years. How does this affect children and families? They suffer from major trauma that you could almost akin to PTSD. Bonds of trust and faith and protection are damaged for years, and some kids never recover. There is a 1 in 7 chance. Kids are 7 times more likely to be abused when they're in foster care, as opposed to being placed with family members. Family members should always be the first option when a removal happens. There is also a stigma attached to CPS. People are afraid to speak up because of the way it looks. This is where my idea for parents advocating change came into. I had my own dealings with CPS, and while going through it, heard similar cases that were eerily the same, and they happened over and over again. None of the issues of my own or other people's cases were ever addressed or fixed. That is our purpose tonight. To show that this system is flawed and to show that we want to work together to fix the situation. It would be nice for parents to have the support that they needed at this time instead of feeling shame. That support should come from all people involved in this situation. You cannot fix everything by giving everyone the same laundry list to check off, which unfortunately tends to happen in CPS. Not every family is the same, so why should the individual issues be handled the same? PAC's mission is to pave a way for those who have brought these issues to the forefront and so that we can correct them and work the system to be more effective, the way that it was meant to be. This night tonight is about awareness, ours as well as theirs. We need to all work together for a common goal. Here is a brief, short list of issues. 1, parents are pushed into situations where they do not even know their constitutional rights. 2, caseworkers are overwhelmed and cannot handle the caseloads without severe stress. 3, problems fall through the cracks because of overloaded caseworkers. And 4, issues do not get handled properly when they arise due to communication breakdowns. And while this is but a brief overview and there are many more issues that should be addressed, this list is showing some of the most vital issues. I believe in parents' rights. And I'm supported by the United States Constitution in protecting the rights of families. No matter what the situation or the station, you have God-given rights afforded to you as an American. As a person, I'm one of the firmest supporters of this right, and that's why I chose to become part of a mission to protect these rights. I also cherish the hope that all sides can work together to find a solution to the problems that plague and burden this system. This will help our families grow stronger as we provide a more compassionate system in the long run. It would also erase and perhaps change the stigma and shame that many feel when they go through this system. In today's world, we need our families to be stronger and not to be picked apart at the seams. I do not know what the solution is, but I feel if we all came together, we could find something that would work. To close, I feel it's only appropriate to say thank you to all of the families who have been through the system and had the courage to speak up about their dismay and loss in the face of how our government agencies sometimes work. It's because of you that PAC strives to bring awareness to the cracks within the system that people fall through every day. Let us rally together to show ourselves, as well to others, that change can be positive and made through the efforts of concerned parents. Thank you all for your time and attention. Enjoy the rest of your evening, and remember, love, not fear.